once your tray of bait has thawed just a little bit and you're able to take these herring apart without damaging scales, it's always a good idea with the Brine and Bite Complete to run three different trays, one natural, one chartreuse, and one blue. And what I do is if I only have one flat of herring, I'll divide those up amongst them. So you got four, four, and four. And the Brine and Bite Complete, like I said, is a natural, chartreuse, and blue. And each of these have their certain days are just better than others, so it's always a good idea to be prepared. And when you go to use it, it's very, very user-friendly. Just cover the baits to where you just got enough in there just to cover them up.
And then this should be, once you have bait and you put this, you should put them in a shelf in the refrigerator. Especially if your home's at 70 degrees or whatnot, once you're brining baits, it's important to keep them refrigerated during this process.
And shake your chartreuse up. Just make sure all the ingredients are mixed in there well. Cover them just till they're covered. Then you got your natural.
Now keep in mind, this is enough to do 6 to 8 trays of bait. Not all at once, but over time. You can do a tray here and a tray there. You can add 2 cups of distilled water to this to make it a larger solution, but this does not need refrigeration. It can sit on the shelf in your garage, and all you have to do when you go to use it next time, just shake it up and pour it over your bait. So this will last a whole year or more just sitting on the shelf in your garage. But once you've had bait in the brine, you can reuse it, but you've got to keep it refrigerated. You don't want the brine to ever go warm. If it does at the end of the day, then it's time to discard the brine and start over. And this is a 4 to 6 hour process to get in and firm the baits up. So I normally do them after dinner when I'm done with my dinner for the night. If I'm fishing the next day, I'll put brine to the baits, put them on the shelf in the fridge, and they're ready to go in the morning. Now these are loaded with all the bite stimulants, the UV, everything's in the Brine and Bite Complete. But the only other thing that I would do to make yours a little different than the boat next to you, you can add tuna powder, krill powder, or the bait spice. So the bait spice is just rock salt that we bedded other baits on when we're preserving them and stabilizing them. But even just, you know, a scoop per container would just make yours a little bit different than the boat next to you, right? So it could be sardine, it could be crawfish, it could be tuna, right? It just depends on what bait we're doing for that day. Then all we do with this is just kind of, you know, as it thaws, this will absorb in and just add a separate scent to your baits. And mainly it's just making you different from the boat next to you. And like I said, you can do the same with krill powder. You can put in a teaspoon of krill powder, a teaspoon of tuna powder. And the cool thing with our Brine and Bite Complete is at the end of the day, any bait you haven't used, you can remove from the brine and wrap up and roll up in a Ziploc baggie and throw it in the freezer. Cover your brine solution and keep it refrigerated. And the night before you're gonna fish again, take those same baits out of the freezer, put them back in the brine, and it'll recharge them and they'll be ready to go. So it'll save you a lot of money on buying bait, just reusing your bait.